we are going to discuss the topic, that is PCOS. See, that's very important disease. It comes under the infertility. Let's see what is PCOS. PCOS means polycystic ovarian syndrome. Polycystic ovarian syndrome means many cysts can found in the ovary. According to the this definition, the meaning is like that. Many cystic formation present in the ovary, that is PCOS. Now, before 2003, every doctors from every places, they are saying this is the symptoms for PCOS and that's the symptom for PCOS. No, this is the symptoms for PCOS. So finally, what they are doing means they arranged one meeting. And it was held in the Rotterdam, the place, Rotterdam, okay. And then they finally discussing everything and they concluded one thing. That is Rotterdam 2003 criteria. Rotterdam 2003 criteria. According to this criteria, the first thing is anovulation. Second thing is hyperandrogen. And the third one, this point we have to pay attention. Third thing, the follicle. Follicle is more than or equal to 12. More than or equal to 12 follicles. And the size. The size is 2 to 9 millimeter. The size. Next thing, the ovary volume. Ovary volume more than 10 milliliter. See, according to that Rotterdam criteria, if you found 3 out of 2, sure the patient have PCOS. Anovulation, hyperandrogen, then the follicles greater than or equal to 12, and the size 2 to 9 millimeter, and the ovary volume more than 10 milliliter. So out of 3, if you find 2 criteria, that's the patient have PCOS. Next thing, see, we already studied the HPO axis, we already know. For that ovulation means, if anovulation means the ovulation does not happen or ovulation absent. According to HPO axis, if the ovulation does not happen means which thing is more in the body? FSH. Yes. FSH will increase in the body. Because master again sending the work, but servant can't accept the work. That's why, and the anovulation FSH will increase in the body, and the same thing, estrogen also increase. What about the progesterone? Progesterone decrease or progesterone absent. So whenever you hear not only the PCOS, whenever you hear the anovulation, think always estrogen positive, progesterone negative. That's the main thing, not only for PCOS, if some of the other disease also, if you are hearing the word anovulation, the patient or she have estrogen level will high and the progesterone level will low. Now, this hyperandrogen release the more testosterone. This hyperandrogen released more testosterone. If the testosterone more means that when the testosterone level will increase, it means hyperthecosis, because theca cells only produced testosterone. So hyperandrogen, the term means increasing of the androgen that leads to increasing of the testosterone. The testosterone level will increase, that means what about the theca cells function, that also working more. That's why I wrote here hyperthecosis. See, normally the follicular size, follicle size, normally the follicle size 18 to 20 millimeter. See, follicle will grow step by step. When it will reach the 18 to 20 ml only, it will change into the graafian follicles. Graafian follicles. See, why this testosterone or hyperthecosis occur means here aromatization is not to take place. Means defective aromatization. You all already know what is aromatization. Aromatization is a conversion from testosterone to the estrogen. Whenever the testosterone does not converted into the estrogen, the testosterone content will more in the body. That's the main thing. And then remember one thing. You can ask me, anovulation, you already told the estrogen level will increase in the body. But here you are saying testosterone will increase in the body. How it can be happened? This is the main thing. In the PCOS, we have to remember the main things. Aromatization, I already told you, aromatization take place in ovary also. And yes, peripheral adipose tissue. This defective aromatization means aromatization process absent in ovary. That's why testosterone level will increase in the body. And what about the aromatization in peripheral tissue? Here converting the testosterone again estrogen, here converting the testosterone into estrogen, that way estrogen level will increase in the body. At the same time, testosterone level to increase in the body. Please pay attention of this point. Estrogen also increased in the body, at the same time testosterone also increased in the body. See, and the main thing you have to know, long standoff PCOS means the patient who are having PCOS, she does not undergoing the treatment, means what it can leads to. PCOS leads to endometrial cancer. So long standoff PCOS leads to endometrial cancers. Now see how we can diagnose. I already told you, according to Rotterdam criteria, if you find out 3 out of 2, sure the disease is PCOS. Now see, normally we have FSH by LH ratio. The value is 2 by 1. The normal value is 2 by 1. When we are going to measure the FSH by LH ratio, means at the second to third day of menstruation. At the second to third day of menstruation. This one is normal. This one I am saying normal thing. When the FSH by LH ratio 2 by 1. Then what about the PCOS? In the PCOS, FSH by LH is 1 by 2 or 1 by 3 or 1 by 4. 1 by 2, 1 by 3 or 1 by 4.